I sip way too much drink. I don't think I can think. I won't try to tell lies. This blunt got me too high. I won't try to pretend.
Yo, 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 what it do? What's poppin', fellas? No, we back.
Now we live.
Another episode. Episode number 5. G, what it do?
All right, let's see if we get
it. Oh, G's smoking, so I'm going to take over. Camera, switch on me.
Switch over, man.
Yo, you welcome. Oh, you're welcome. You're
all
fucking welcome.
Not as easy as it looks, is it?
Oh, it is. Let's go. Get it, Crumb. You can do this, Crumb.
Oh,
come on, Crumb. You can do this,
back
Crumb.
To Blunt Exchange.
Woo!
And you know what we do on Blunt Exchange? We keep shit blunt.
Yes, sir.
So I'm just going to light this up and make sure we get it rocking.
Yeah.
And like we always say on Blunt Exchange, pull up, roll up, light up,
and
let's get blunt. Welcome back to Blunt Exchange. Throw them X's up, everybody.
Yo, yo.
This is episode 5.
Cinco.
And we are happy to be back.
Hell yeah.
Back in studio 115.
Woo!
Oh, hell yeah. How was everybody's weekend?
Fire.
Fire.
Fire?
Yes.
Anything to discuss or just fire? Like, there's nothing.
A lot of still. I think I'm still going to Friendsgivings. I don't know what.
I feel like Friendsgiving should be all year round. Like, you should do like once a month or
hell
something
yeah.
like that.
Hell yeah.
But then again, it might take away from the luster of the actual Friends Thanksgiving season.
We just got to keep changing the name. Mm-hmm. Friendsgiving, Bluntsgiving.
March giving. April's giving.
Every giving. We just got to continue to give.
Something like that. Anything interesting?
Yesterday was my birthday.
Happy birthday, Crump!
Yo,
yo. Yo, man.
Oh, man.
One time.
Can we get a toast for
one
that?
One time.
Oh, definitely.
Yeah.
I mean.
Congratulations. Another trip around the sun, my guy.
Another trip. Thank you.
We're finally doing it.
Old man shit.
They said we wasn't supposed to make it past 25. Mm. The joke's on you. We still alive,
motherfuckers.
Still alive, baby.
Now we got a podcast.
Classic Kanye bars. Classic Kanye. I know that's your man.
That's really been
that's my
man.
I can't fuck with it. I fucks with that Christian album, too.
Oh, man. Anything new for y'all?
Anything new with y'all?
Nah, this weekend I actually didn't do anything this weekend. I worked and then I just was watching a lot of Netflix. Yo, okay. Please, in the comments, give me some suggestions of stuff to watch on Netflix. I want to talk about Top Boy. I want to give y'all the Top Boy information, but the problem is that Crump won't start watching Top Boy.
I haven't watched it yet. Oops.
We asked you to start watching Top Boy like 3 episodes ago.
¿Y qué pasó?
You haven't started it. What's going on?
He didn't watch, right?
My bad.
Your birthday was yesterday.
Yeah, I was prepping. I was prepping for my birthday.
You was prepping for your birthday. So it takes like 3-4 weeks for you to get ready for your birthday.
I mean, I had to do it up. Do it big, baby.
Big
what
time.
It do, baby?
Are you one of those people that when your birthday comes up, like you turn into like a birthdayzilla? Like, like everything goes. You don't care about what anybody else has going on. Oh, you have work? You have work? I don't care if you're a doctor and you have to do a surgery. It's my birthday.
Hell yeah.
Mom.
You better show up.
Mom, it's my 36th birthday.
Oh, now you have cancer. Yeah.
Oh,
now you have cancer and I have to go to chemo. It's my birthday. Stop being selfish, Mom.
Mom, it's my 26th birthday. Yo, you know how important this is.
Nah, like, I can't condone that.
Man, I've met so many people that when their birthday comes up, they lose all like rational thinking. They don't even know how to.
I used to be one of those.
You used to be one of those?
Hell yeah.
How long does your birthday celebration last when you
4 days.
Your birthday? 4 days?
No, right now? Right now it's 4 days. It used to last weeks before.
Weeks?
Yeah.
Like the month?
The entire month.
Okay.
And mine's is at the beginning of the month. Mine is
celebrated like a bad bitch.
Yeah.
Celebrated for a month
Make
straight.
It rain. I'm a thot. Get me lit.
Crump, how was the weekend?
It was cool. Like I said, birthday was yesterday. I didn't do much. I didn't do nothing. I chilled out. Like I said, Kepler, super regular, super light, super... Super chill, so I don't got nothing to talk about.
Nothing to talk about? Any gifts?
On.
Any special gifts? Special gifts for your birthday?
Gifts.
Birthday threesome, birthday threesome,
birthday threesome, birthday threesome.
You got the birthday threesome off?
I forgot to ask for the birthday
threesome. You forgot to ask for the birthday threesome?
Who's waiting for this, man?
Who forgets to ask for the birthday threesome?
Was waiting.
I asked for the Tuesday threesome.
I know. I was
the titty Tuesday threesome.
I was doing so much that I forgot to ask for the birthday threesome.
Oh my goodness.
Maybe I can ask for it now.
Yes, you
but
still
your birthday
can.
Passed. So
no, no, he still
now
got. It's under 72 hours.
It's even easier to decline. Like it's not even your birthday for real.
It's still under 72 hours.
Maybe next year.
I would have.
Yeah, if you asked, I would have. Maybe next year.
Yeah, maybe Christmas reason.
You still got 72 hours, Crump. Get it done. Get it done.
The reindeer
in the manger.
Not in the manger.
Oh, but at least a little bit of swaddling clothes, though. You feel me? A little swaddle. A little swaddle. Nah.
All right.
Nah.
I can't do it.
You still got 72 hours, Crump. Get it done. You could get it done. Yo, bro, I watched this movie.
What movie?
Sleep Doctor. Has anybody talked to you about that movie, Sleep Doctor?
I have no idea.
Wow, bro.
But Bleak, please, bro, tell me more.
Nah, that movie is OD good.
What is it on?
I watched it on Cody.
But how could me, somebody who
my
observed,
bad.
Shout out to Omni and the Hellcat.
Yeah, man.
But how
you
would
did
a person,
great things for us.
Yeah, yeah. You're a legend and a hero. But how would somebody
that
like me who
word.
Oh, we'll no, get to that later. We'll get to that later. Yeah. But how can somebody like me,
yeah,
a law-abiding citizen?
I think it's still in theaters.
A law-abiding citizen.
I think it's
how
still
do
in theaters.
I watch it? It's still in theaters?
I think
and
so.
What's it called
Gerard
again? Sleep
Butler.
Doctor?
Sleep Doctor. All it's right, like the sequel to The Shining. If you watch The Shining, if you know anything about that. You know, Stephen King.
I actually do know what you're talking about, and that was very highly recommended.
Bro, it's insane. It's so good.
There's supposed to be a show which is almost like the same, it's the same storyline, and it's on like Amazon, I think. It's called, I don't remember the name of it. We'll look it up and we'll put it on the screen.
Yeah.
And it's an, also like a Stephen, based on a Stephen King, same area.
Yeah.
It's some place in like Maine, right? Something like that.
Is it New York? It's like, yeah.
Most of his stories take place in either like New York or like Maine or something.
That's where it's from.
Yeah, so.
Wow, man. Really good, man. Recommended. Insane.
And that
good
show
horror movie.
Was highly recommended by a person that I actually respect their opinion and
their views.
Yeah. Their views.
Well, what's everybody's favorite genre of movie, real quick?
Ooh.
Favorite genre of movie?
Yeah.
That's tough.
I
think, to be honest, I watch more. I love to watch comedies. I usually enjoy comedies a lot.
Yeah.
But I like horror, dramas. Like I like everything. You know, I'm a cinephile.
I think comedy is my favorite type of genre movie. Yeah. I like funny shows. I like funny movies.
What's your favorite comedy?
Favorite comedy? It's a
Anchorman.
Anchorman. Woo! Step Brothers. All
whiskey,
the Will Ferrell
whiskey,
movies.
Whiskey.
What about like the classics?
Oh no, I love like
whiskey.
I love Friday. I love the Fridays. I love
Coming to America.
Coming to America. They're coming on with a second one.
Friday.
I hope not.
Friday,
but okay.
What was that? What was that real? I'll
Menace
say it
to Society. Boys
no,
to the
not
Hood.
Funny. That's not a comedy though.
Oh. Yeah, I was just talking about classics. My fault.
Oh.
The Wash.
Yeah, All the classic movies are mad funny. I love
them. Hollywood Shuffle. All Look that up, guys. Hollywood Shuffle. That's something you should have seen if you've never seen that.
Yeah. Is that the one with Robert Townsend movie?
Robert Townsend.
Oh, yeah. That's a great movie.
Hollywood Shuffle. Check that out. Word of the day.
Word of the day.
Word of the day.
Mm-hmm.
Word of the day today is egregious.
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 Yes.
Egregious.
Does anyone know what that means?
Like flagrant. Like flagrant.
Like too much.
Like it's like,
ugh.
Ugh. Ugh. So it's like Pusha T.
You guys,
it's like Pusha T's ad lib.
Pusha T's.
Ugh.
Ugh. Do you guys care to elaborate any more than that?
I mean,
give it a shot.
Grossly disrespected.
Yeah,
like you're getting
much.
Disrespected.
It's
so crazy.
Yeah, it's too much. It's
too much.
It's unpleasant.
So, guys, egregious. Egregious means outstandingly bad or shocking. So the sentence that they have here is egregious abuses of copyright.
Yeah.
Mm. Egregious abuses of copyright.
Yeah, that's like taking.
So egregious is outstandingly bad.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I get it. Okay.
Butt of the day.
Butt of the day. Welcome back. It's the butt of the day moment. Brought to you by White Runts.
White Runts.
White Runts.
We had Runts on one of the other episodes, and that.
Show them, Bleak. Show camera two.
It's hybrid.
We were slapped off the Runts.
Yeah.
You remember that? It got crazy.
I don't remember it.
We definitely will. So you think that's going to happen again?
I mean, it's the White Runts.
I can't wait. I can't wait.
So we're going to put that in the air, right? Well, momentarily, we'll put that in the air. And then we'll also put the information up for the White Runts. And, you guys try to get a hand on that, and try that for yourselves and let us know. Yes, sir. And actually give us some more, suggestions on what we should try to look for, try to get, or send us some stuff, man. Our information, BluntExchange@gmail.com, BluntExchange, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube. And don't forget to subscribe and follow on all social media platforms.
All of them.
Every single one.
You dig?
Yeah, so guys, the butt of the day, we had White Runs.
Yes.
All right, so guys, I was talking to a friend the other day, and they asked me a question, and I thought it was super interesting, and I would love to get feedback on it, especially from you guys, and then you guys at home. I would love to get some feedback from you on the situation.
Damn.
Here we go.
You are with your girlfriend, right?
Okay. Uh-huh.
And you guys are going out for the night to a club or a party.
With your girlfriend.
I mean, of course, relationships. This is what we go through. People need to know. People
We're
need
adults.
To.
Adults.
Yeah.
All right.
You know?
Let's go.
So you and your girl are going out to a party or the club or a lounge, something. You're going out for the night together.
Yeah. Going to Dykeman. Let's go.
Or a strip club. You know, you're getting it lit.
Okay.
And you, your best friend tags along. So he's third wheeling it.
Yeah.
He tags
along. Which is cool. It's cool.
And throughout the process, throughout the course of the night,
yeah,
you get twisted.
Like, most likely.
Out of your mind.
Most likely. Right?
To the point where you're like incapacitated. You can't drive home. Your girl's twisted. She can't really drive, but she's nowhere as messed up as you are.
Okay.
So your boy has to drive, right?
Got it.
Where should your girl sit in the car?
In the back seat.
Back seat.
I mean,
whoa. What?
Does she need to sit in the back seat? Would you feel some kind of way if she didn't sit in the back seat?
Why would she sit anywhere else other than the back seat?
Because the front seat is more comfortable?
Oh, no.
Nah.
And she's already sitting? She would be already
She wouldn't. She's not already,
earlier?
No,
what?
She adjusts.
Yeah, she's sitting in the back.
So is there an issue if she sits in the front?
Yeah, there's an issue.
Why would there be an issue for that?
Because we're not having conversations in the front seat while I'm in the back.
But you're twisted. You're knocked out.
She
might have to direct him to go. Like, that's what if I want to go to get something to eat real quick. She knows the way to the spot. He doesn't know which spot y'all go to.
What do you call those? Those unwritten rules? Like those rules you don't even speak about? Like those things?
So so you're twisted and she knows that you're going to be mad hungry when you snap out of this or you come back. They can't go in and get you some food. Like let's stop at the spot that we get the food.
Yeah, I mean,
go in and get it.
Are you changing? Now we're on a new subject.
No. This is the same subject.
Wait.
This is the same subject. So she can't sit in the front. So now we get to the food spot. Can they go get the food?
Yeah, why she can't get the food?
Like they get
we're
the
not
food.
Buying. She's not buying him food.
No, he wants to get his own food.
Yeah, so he goes in there and gets his own food.
But you're twisted, so you're in the car. So they both go together. That's cool.
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay.
What's wrong with
she's
that?
Not,
so then I don't understand what the car thing is.
Because
there's no need for her to be in the front seat.
It's more comfortable.
Girls.
I mean, she has the whole back seat.
You have the whole back seat.
No, she has the whole back seat because it's more comfortable.
But you're back there twisted. She doesn't want to get Earled on.
What?
There's a possibility you Earl on her. You're twisted in the back seat.
How?
Because you're twisted.
No.
Oh, my fault.
Let me ask you this.
Don't get twisted.
Nah, so if your girl does sit in the front, how do you feel about that?
First of all, I'm a real one. I don't throw up.
Try again.
What happened?
We'll try it again. What was the question?
It was if, I'm asking you, if your girl was to sit in the front, not in the back with you, how do you...
How would I feel about that?
Yeah, are you okay with that?
Okay, so there's two ways I would answer this question, right?
really, two ways?
Can we just get the answer first and then you explain your way out of it? Can we just get the answer first?
Oh, Jack, Crump is on you today.
So, okay, Mr. Tough Guy. So what's the question? Ask me the question then.
So you're too twisted to drive.
Okay.
And do you want your girl to sit in the front seat with your best man while y'all drive home?
And I don't get to ask you no questions. That's the question.
I'm just saying. We said no, and then we told you why we said no. So
I get to say my answer.
We're asking you why, if it's okay with you for your girl to sit
I would like
in the front.
To say yes, it would be okay, because I know my girl ain't doing shit, and I don't want to have to Earl on her if something goes down, because I'm wild twisted in the backseat. I'm going to be sprawled out. I'm a big dude. I'm not like 5'6 or nothing.
I don't believe
you. You feel me?
I'm not a small dude.
Hold on. Let me finish my answer. I would like to say, yes, she can sit wherever she wants to sit, because first of all, I don't control her. And at the same point in time, I'm twisted. So I get it.
Oh, you don't control her?
But to be honest, if I'm blackout twisted,
it's kind of sketchy.
I could like wake up every now and then and see them in the front seat. I don't know what I'm putting together in my mind.
Oh.
So I can understand why I would feel a little a little off about it. But at the same point time, it's my girl. If it's my girl, I should, everything I don't should know, be all right.
Let's say you
everything should be all right.
Let's say you should be all right. Bet. Okay, hold on. Bring the camera on me. Hold on. Bring the camera on me. All right, so I got a scenario for you.
Go ahead.
Bet. She's in the front seat, right?
Yeah.
Boom. She's on her phone, hits the bump.
Oh.
Her phone falls. On like in between under his feet. He's like, I'm gonna get it, and she's like, nah, I got it. Yo, don't like, we all were partying, just focus on driving.
Yeah, don't move.
And that's the moment you wake up and you see her head, like her, like, I mean, her whole head
reaching,
top half body, like, I mean, underneath his legs, looking like, I mean, she's doing something. I don't even want that.
You don't want that possibility. That's a,
I mean,
wild,
I don't even
scenario,
want that.
Like,
you giving me, you're talking about, yo, I don't want to throw up on her.
Yeah, because I'm twisted. The whole scenario.
What does that even mean?
The whole premise.
Yo, my
is,
man, I'm about to throw up. Pull the car over. Or put your window up. I'm going to just stick half my body out the car and throw up as we drive.
So it's super unrealistic that you can just have a violent, and throw up real quick.
You said she's a little twisted.
She's a little twisted. You're super twisted.
Yeah. All right. But. So that's a possibility that she can have her phone in her hand and hit a pothole or a speed bump and lose the phone.
Okay. So she loses the phone. I look up and at the same exact minute,
she's like,
it looks like she's in his lap.
Yeah.
Feel like she's topping.
See, yeah. I would know that my girl's top is so crazy.
Oh,
that,
man.
If I don't hear shit and there's not a whole bunch of steam on the windows,
listen,
or something,
man,
and the car ain't doing
she's,
nothing
she's
crazy,
custom. She sits
then
she's
not
front
topping.
Seat. She sits in the
she's
front
not doing
seat
that
all the time.
Because if she was doing that, I would know.
She reaches over all the time when you're driving, man. Things get comfortable.
Yeah, she's drunk.
Yeah.
She might just think that
she might
that's
just slouch
you
over a
and
bit.
That's not mean.
You feel me?
Okay,
she
now,
might just slouch over.
Not mean.
Your man's might
she's
just
a little twisted.
A little
she might just think that's you. She might have fell asleep, woke up, thought it was you, tried to undo your man's pants.
Wow.
Know what I mean?
And then,
boom, boom,
then
boom,
my,
boom.
Then my homeboy, who's not that twisted, should just be like, yo, you're
twisted.
What are you doing?
Oh, how about I do it, then I'll tell you later. Like, yo. It happened, I gotta tell you. Oh, you couldn't stop it, no, but I had to tell you after.
How many, what are the percentage of men do you think that's not letting their man's girl
yeah.
do something versus how many are letting their man's girl do something?
So what percentage of men do I think would allow their girl to not allow
no, not,
would be all right with their
no
girl
no, no 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 what percentage of men do you think with if I'm his man's and I'm driving and my man's girl wakes up and thinks that I'm him and she starts to try and undo my pants or something like that, what's the percentage of men do you think that'll actually let her continue on and know what I mean?
It depends how hard she's going, I think, honestly.
Wow.
Like, if she's, like, reaches over, like, and says, you know, hey, it's AIM, and he's like, wait a minute, I'm not AIM. Like, you know, chill out. You're twisted.
Yeah.
But if she's on some aggressive shit, I feel like a lot of dudes, I'm driving, you know, I might get the first 15, you might get the preview off.
Wow.
The preview of the video.
Wow.
And then stop it. Pull over.
This is not it.
Get the first 8 seconds.
I don't want any of these
first
scenarios.
First 8 seconds.
Does that mean
you know
a couple
I don't want any
strokes
of these
or a couple
first, I'm good.
The first 8 seconds.
I'm taking
seconds
the Uber. Fuck this.
Yeah, I'm getting out of the car.
You might get to brandish the iron.
Yeah.
And then.
Nah.
You might not use it, but it might get brandished.
I don't think.
If you're cool with that, if your man tells you that the next day, it's all right because she was mad aggressive.
Oh, no. Murder game for everybody. For everybody involved, murder game.
So
if my girl topped you.
So what? So hold on.
If my girl topped you.
So let me ask you a question.
It's an issue.
So you just said that you could probably get to brandish this cannon off. Are you saying that that's all men? Which men are you saying that is? Because if that's what you think it is, then are you saying that that's what, as far as you'll let it get to?
No, I don't think I'm like most men.
All right, so you think most
I'm different.
So you think most men will let the shorty brandish the cannon?
Yes.
Okay.
I think most men will. If she's going, like I told you,
it all
depends on how
if she's
hard
she's like,
going,
yo, come
like,
on, you know
yeah.
I'm on it.
It's me, like, you know what
yo,
I mean?
Yo, it's me.
And you're like, yo, it's clearly I'm not him. And she's still like, yo,
no,
you
no,
are
no,
him.
No,
I can
hold
see
on,
it,
hold on,
it's
hold on.
You.
If she's,
oh, you're
hold on,
twisted.
Are you saying that he's saying it's not me, I'm just so and so? Or are you just saying, shorty?
Yo.
You know it's not me.
I think if it's your best friend, most. I changed my answer. If it's your best friend,
shut it
I
down.
Think most of your dudes are just going to shut that the fuck down. Like, yeah, yo, shorty, chill the fuck out. You're wildin'. What's wrong with
that's
you?
What I'm
you're
saying.
Twisted.
I don't even want to be.
Get the fuck out of here.
You gotta be in the front seat.
And then she starts crying because women, as soon as you tell them something wrong, they start crying.
And then I wake up now because I'm drunk, and I wake up, and now I really think something happened.
Yeah, you like what's the name?
This is a crazy situation. Yeah. Yo, you gotta hit us up in the comments and tell us what you think about that.
I think most men wouldn't want their shorty to sit in the front.
I feel like most men is never gonna want their shorty to sit next to a dude for anything. Like,
I think most stand up women would want to sit in the back seat.
Yeah. And there you go.
Stand up women.
There
now
you
made
go.
It different. Like now,
that's
so
how you
if they
it.
Don't do it, they're not a stand up woman. What if they? What if the front seat is more comfortable? What if my girl is tall?
No.
And
so
what if it's like a hatchback or something like that?
Yeah.
What if I'm definitely sitting in the back? No way you sitting in the front. You're way too close. No. I don't want to hear shit.
Sheesh, Louise.
Nah, fuck that.
All right, so hit us up in the comments and let us know how you feel about that. Should your girl sit in the front seat with another man, even if you're twisted and incapacitated and you can't do anything?
And ladies, hit us up. What would you do?
Yeah, how would you feel? How would you feel if the roles were reversed?
Oh, that's
Let us know. You feel me?
Hey, I don't think girls. Have
I don't think girls would let that rock. Period.
Yeah. Like if you was with, if you was with your shorty and her friend, and it was her car, and y'all went out. And
I'm sitting
like,
in the front.
I'm too drunk to drive.
I'm sitting in the front.
Like if you so let's say I have a question.
Okay. Hit us with the question.
I'm ready for this. All right, boom. So you go out with your girl and her friend, right? You go, same scenario, you go out to the club, y'all get drunk, right? Yeah. She drove. Your
Blasted.
Friend your girl's friend drove. She's too drunk to drive. She's like, "Yo, G, drive because I'm too twisted to drive." And you're like, "Okay."
All right. Cool.
She's starting to like she's motioning to sit in the front seat.
Mm-hmm.
Are you saying, yo? Are you asking her like, yo? Do you mind if my girl sits in the front seat with me, or are you gonna let your shorty sit in the back seat?
So to be honest, this is what I would do. You wanna ask this question
Let
me rock?
No, go ahead, rock.
This is what I would do, and this is dead ass. This is what I would do. I would look at my shorty.
Yes.
And catch the vibes.
I feel that.
Ooh.
And my shorty, if she doesn't feel no kind of way about this girl, like, it would be some shit like, yeah, whatever. Like, let's hurry up, let's get this over with. Like, let's get home.
All right.
Or if she's looking at her like, nah, I don't fuck with this bitch. Like, but yeah, my shorty, let her sit in the front. Like, you know how it is. You know what I mean? And I feel like it would be all right.
I got this. If you're dating a Latina, she's sitting in the front. Over. And that's that.
But it's the other girl's car, though.
It don't matter.
No matter
no
what.
No girl is going to allow any other girl to sit in the front with her man driving. If she's a Latina, it's not happening. Even if she is black, it's not happening. Those women are territorial. Very, 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 very territorial.
No matter what.
No matter what.
What if the other girl is like super...
If you dare to not let your girl sit in the front...
How many different types of Spanish girls have you gone out with? Have you gone out with pretty much like Puerto Rican, Dominican?
Yeah, Puerto
like
Rican, Dominican.
You mean
yeah.
Hispanic?
Hispanic.
Yeah. How many Hispanic?
Latina X? What was he? What is
Latin? How many different Latin?
You identify Latinx as Latinx?
No, I don't. I don't even know what that is.
Now
I'm
we're talking
school.
About identification. I'm what just, do you what do you identify all that as? Shit.
Me?
Latino.
As a human being.
Respect.
Mm-hmm.
I agree with that.
Respect.
Thank you.
All right, so what were you saying? How many different Hispanic women? Are you going somewhere with that? Or are you just...
I was just seeing how the territorial thing goes. Going out with a bunch.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah, so, no, I've dated
a few.
What were
we just on just now? Before
we were talking about the women and riding in the front seat of your girl. Like
okay,
your
switching it around. Yeah, because the thing I would say is, like, if it is the other woman's car, right? Mm-hmm. For example.
Yeah.
And it's like a regular sedan. Let's say something smaller, like I don't want to say a car name, but like,
okay.
Just to give you the idea.
Yeah,
like a Corolla or something.
Right. Oh, that's all that.
You know, and the girl is tall, right?
Right.
And why are we talking about Corollas?
Because of the size of the car. I'm just setting the scenario. Like, I'm just putting some more parameters on the scenario.
Gotcha. Civic.
Like, you know, that size. And she's like, yo, I'm definitely sitting in the front seat because one, it's my car.
Maybe a Fiat. I'm sorry.
Okay. One, it's my car.
Yeah.
And two, I'm tall and I can't fit in the back seat.
Oh,
you asshole.
You see, but that's you. Okay.
So what is your girl going to do then? She's going to be an asshole?
No.
I think she's understanding.
I don't think so. But if she
is
drunk,
your girl's understanding
if she's drunk, I think she might do it.
The
If she's drunk,
if that's the what's the code we're working with, yeah, I think she's understanding.
She's gonna understand that. What if she pulls like how your last scenario was, Kerb? She pulls as soon as she's in the car, like, no, make sure you do this, and she like reaches over to like, you know, like
the gear shift,
like you got to do. No, this is something on my seat, like
How do I pull the seat back? Oh, like this.
Oh yeah, this is how you. You think your girl's gonna wild out? She can do
wild this? Out,
or she's gonna say something?
No, she's wilding out.
Yeah, she's
if she switches, she's wilding out.
Just like Molly Wap.
How about that? How about you're the driver? Your shorty's the one drunk. Does she sit in the back, or do you sit with the best friend in the front?
Your shorty's the one that's drunk.
Yeah. It's you, right? It's you, your shorty, and your shorty's best friend.
She's like,
it depends how twisted she is.
She's twisted. She's inebriated, out of control.
Twisted.
Yeah. Oh my God. You know how women are after four shots.
I don't know how all women are, because all women are different, and all women are special and unique.
I respect women,
and I respect them, and I always ask for consent.
I always ask for consent.
Consent first.
Every time, sign.
You know?
Right here.
Do you know that they consent could always boys. Consent, boys? You know consent they could. Boys you know they the could building. Always change their mind, yeah. And then you have to respect that too.
You should always ask consent.
For sexual. Second consent.
Bleak.
Yes.
Do you feel that you should ask for consent, like continuously
upon
through
new
a
levels.
Session?
New levels.
Like I think time so. A new level, level. Is
yes.
introduced.
Yes. Yes.
Like,
do you agree with this?
Do you agree? Yes.
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 Keep continue.
May. Yeah. May I go deeper?
Yes. May I slap?
May I continue slapping?
May I pull?
Yeah, consent first, guys. Always ask for consent.
Always.
And women, that goes for you too.
But,
yeah.
Like we were saying.
Because
like,
women, it's a double standard with consent. Because they don't ask for consent.
They just take it.
They just do what they want.
And they take pride in that too. They take pride in that. And just being that aggressive and jumping on you and. And then after you smash, they'll be like, yeah, but I did it. Like, what?
But you know,
and then you'd be like, I let you, right? You gotta play that card and kind of be like, ugh. But then you call your boys on the chat.
I'm conflicted because I don't ever want to argue against a woman taking what she wants.
True.
But consent is important, very important.
So would you let your girl's best friend sit in the front, or would you still let your girlfriend sit in the front? Even though
if I'm driving, it's my car, and no matter how twisted my girl is, she's sitting in the front seat.
Okay, no matter how twisted it is.
Yeah, like,
gotcha. And then the best friend sits in the back, and she starts playing with your hair or your ear. Oh,
what
shit.
If the best friend is just mad twisted? And she's not even sitting in the front.
Oh, here
but
we
she's
go.
Just
off. That's another one.
She's just twisted. Yeah, like, yeah, so y'all are in the party, y'all leaving the party, and she's on some twisted shit. Like, she's touching on you. And your girl is like, you know, like, yeah, she's twisted. This is my homegirl.
Kill this
like,
bitch.
Super twisted. Yeah. How do you handle that situation?
I'm looking at my girl and telling her, like,
yo, it ain't my fault.
Like,
and
handle this.
Because I can't, if I grab her,
or she just grabs,
her.
What if she just grabs the bowl? Like, you know, y'all walking out the
car. I'm like, oh,
You're going to turn into Andrew like, Dice girl. Clay?
Yeah.
Like, you're going to turn into Andrew Dice Clay. Hey.
I'm gonna look.
It wasn't me. That's what I.
I'm gonna look at my girl and be like, "Yo, you saw that, right?
Yo,
handle your girl. She's twisted. Yo.
And if your girl's a little twisted too, and she's like, "Oh, hey, what the hell?
Oh, so now
then you get to the
birthday threesome. Birthday threesome.
Birthday threesome. Birthday threesome. Birthday threesome.
As fast as you can. I believe in Tuesday threesome too and Wednesday threesome. It doesn't only have to be birthday threesome. You can make a threesome happen any time of year.
Yeah, it's true.
A lot of people would have more threesomes if they just asked for them. People are afraid to ask for threesomes. You should never be afraid to ask for what you want. What's the worst that could happen?
What is the worst?
Divorce.
Divorce? They would divorce you for asking?
Wow.
So.
That's out of control.
I think you got to at least be married for like at least 10, 15 years.
10, 15 years? If you don't have the threesome question before you get married, then you're not doing it right.
Yeah, what the fuck are you doing?
You should know what it is. If that's something you want to get in,
you gotta
and
reach
the other
for
person
the
is like, nah, you might have to like do the threesome real quick and then get back to the relationship and then continue on.
The Lizzo versus Rihanna Jones.
Oh, I love me some Lizzo, B. Yo, Lizzo is fucking... I fucks with this bitch even more now, bro.
Lizzo,
yo,
stop
she came
it.
Through to the LA game.
Stop it.
My brother, that's real shit.
Lizzo, stop
she
it.
She dropped the video today saying, like, I don't give a what y'all haters think.
And stop comparing yourself to exquisite Rihanna.
What?
In her exquisite clothing with her exquisite, beautiful self.
Yo, so if Rihanna
in the privacy of her home with her friends fully clothed, And you're comparing that to massive amounts of ass cheek out in public.
On a public seat.
In a public area.
Yeah, kids is out.
Kids are... You had...
Yo, Lizzo, keep doing your thing, you heard? Keep doing your thing, you heard?
Massive amounts of ass. Like, huge.
And then she dropped even more nudes, too.
Yo, oh, she dropped goodness. Some nudes on IG. Then she came through in LA with her ass out. She tried to take Jordan... What is her name?
Jordan Woods.
Jordan Woods, man. Yo, Carl Anthony Towns.
I don't know if that's really Jordan Woods, man.
No, that's, a, no,
that's
my brother.
That's his official girlfriend?
Yeah, she's claiming that, bro.
And what did she say? Did she say that's something bad?
I saw it on one of my Twitter sports follows that she was like, looking a little thirsty.
Yeah, she's had like the best week ever.
Said Lizzo's looking a little thirsty.
Yeah.
I mean, Lizzo looks like she's thirsty, hungry.
You know who's thirsty when it comes to NBA players? Ben Simmons. I saw that he's back with... Kendall Jenner again after like the eighth time.
Yeah,
like,
man.
She cheated on him like 17 times, I saw.
Yeah, I swear to you that they are like vampires or some shit.
Who?
Like they're like 7,000 years old. The Kardashians, like on some real shit. Like
souls.
They're 7,000 years old and they're never really going to get too old. They might disappear and like 20 years from now I'd be like,
yeah.
The Von Trappens.
The family dies like in a surprise
some crazy
plane
accident,
crash,
and then now some
and
new
they reappear.
It looks similar, but they have blonde hair.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah,
you know what I mean.
Kendall Jenner turns back
because look, all the dudes go to mess with them, and they go insane.
Collapse. Yeah. They collapse.
Like they lose their souls.
Soul snatchers.
Yeah, but you like your man. You thought that album was amazing.
Which one?
Follow God.
Your man was looking
Kanye's
like
album?
The Tin Man.
Yeah.
Fire
your
album.
Your man was looking like the Tin Man for his music.
Kanye West has lost his mind. He looked like foil.
Yo.
Yeah. He looked like Zordon.
He looked like Reynolds rap.
I have no idea what that was.
He looked like
about.
The Jiffy Pop, like the
but
pop
I like
cool.
The album. Yes.
The fast.
Yo, man. If he hasn't gotten in yet, he's not going to get in.
I saw a meme.
These stunts that he's doing, bro.
I saw
bro.
A meme that said, I need to see Gold CeeLo fight. Platinum Kanye.
Man, please.
Out of control. Out of control.
I think he's still trying to get into like the family. And he still hasn't gotten in. He's doing all these crazy fucking
stuff.
Oh, stunts.
Shit. More bleak conspiracy.
Well, he got Kim wearing baggy clothes.
He
bro?
Got Kim wearing baggy clothes. He did the Sunday service
you tight?
With Joel.
You tight?
Joel
you Steve. Tight about that?
About what?
Kim Kardashian wearing baggy clothes.
I mean, that fuck. Kim Kardashian's been washed for a few years now, man.
Okay. Kim Kardashian is washed? They're going to kill you for that, Bleak.
My bad.
You can't say things like that. Don't you? They're vampires.
I know.
They've been around for thousands of years.
Well, they had their
G is censor police.
She needs to get them. She needs to get better blood.
I'm not censoring.
She better suck on some better blood.
Yo, she, all
blood
she has
she's
is
now,
elite.
It ain't.
All she's been, all the blood they've been feasting on has been elite black athlete blood. That's been.
And you ain't no athlete.
That's been what you call it? What's the word I'm looking for?
That true blood?
Nah, they've been bred to have elite blood.
Yeah.
And well, they've been surviving off that for thousands of years.
I don't think they've been getting it for some time because that's it. It's over for her. It's a wrap for all of them. For Khloe, Kourtney.
And mixing with the OJ blood.
Now we got Kendall and Kylie. That's it. That's what we got now.
Got
get rid
OJ
of those, the other
there.
Ones, man. Yeah, we done
just,
with that.
I just want to... So I can't believe Lizzo, just to get back, I can't believe Lizzo compared herself
to Rihanna?
Or was it just the fans were comparing like her ass out to like Rihanna having a white tank top when Rihanna was like fully clothed. With she didn't wear a bra, but for
that's
women
another,
that's cool, right?
Yeah.
That for women you why
that's
you
another argument.
A woman not being
a woman
able to wear like clothes that
man.
She wants to.
She's a confident woman.
I mean, I'm not hating on like I mean Lizzo, but I'm just saying you can't walk around with your ass out at a public sporting event. Like if I wasn't famous, they wouldn't let my girl in with that.
Yeah, I don't understand how anybody can justify or argue the fact that she was dressed inappropriately at the game.
She was doing her thing. She sat her big ass in a public seat.
That's you, Bleak? That's you? You
if you don't like that, bro.
You trying to holler at that?
Eh?
You a Lizzo fan? You down?
Well, she's had the best week ever, I think.
Would you holler at that?
Nah, I won't holler at her.
Why not?
Hell no.
Why not? She's famous.
She's not my type.
Right?
She's not my type.
Didn't you guys say that you would give your last names away for money?
Yes, but she's not my type. So
she's rich.
I said for Oprah money.
She's rich.
She doesn't have Oprah
money. You heard?
Money.
Don't you ever confuse
she has millions,
that.
She might have millions of
Oprah money is for real.
Oh, you don't want to talk about what they, yo.
She might have millions of dollars.
Yeah, you don't want to talk about how much people make a year on money off of music.
We'll get into that another time. You showed me a list earlier this week.
I need a calmer woman in my life.
Was it the top five streams of this year?
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Like that? No, yeah, yeah. I told it to you today.
Yeah.
The top five streamed albums of the year.
Yeah, I want to get into that. I thought that
Post Malone was top two.
Oh. How do you guys feel about Post Malone?
I think he's a good artist. And he makes great music. I can't say he's a great lyricist or a rapper, but he makes great music.
Didn't he just win a Best Rap Award?
He's like in the pop.
Didn't he win a Grammy for Best Rap Award?
He's in the pop section of rap or hip hop. I'm sorry. He's in the pop section of hip hop.
No, no, but he's considered a rapper, right? Am I wrong? Is Post Malone a rapper?
They put his music in the category. Doesn't necessarily mean
so look,
that you're a lyricist. So even look at this category. All of that.
And this is from Academics page, right?
Yeah, Academics.
He posted this. All right, but the biggest hip hop albums of 2019, and this is based on total activity. Post Malone's Hollywood Bleeding. Mm-hmm. Hollywood's Bleeding. Yep. That's 2.6 mil. Okay. Post Malone's Bear Bongs and Bentleys, 1.2 mil. Lil Nas X 7, 1.2 mil. Drake Scorpion, 1.15. And
Drake always finds a way in.
And A Boogie with the Hoodie Season.
A Boogie BX.
Shout out. Yeah, Crumb.
Yeah, you already
so how do you feel about that list? Is that you feel like that's accurate?
Those are the numbers.
Yeah, that's I believe those are. There's only a few people that are actually doing numbers. I feel in music, so, and these are some of the people that are doing the numbers. I think there are more. I think there are probably a couple more that maybe make a million total things that they're according to. But yeah, Post Malone had a crazy year.
So is it safe to say? Is it safe to say that Post Malone is dominating rap?
No.
He's dominating the hip hop.
It's not safe to say
genre.
That, cuz that's not true.
I mean, it's safe to say by the numbers.
Nah, man.
He's like a million and change up on everybody.
And? I don't mean nothing. Is that the YouTube numbers?
He has the top 2 albums.
Is that the YouTube numbers? Is that the SoundCloud numbers? This is a lot of streams platforms.
I can only imagine his YouTube.
I don't know what platforms they're talking about with these numbers.
Platforms.
Nah, he don't nothing.
His music was everywhere. Movies, it was everything. Commercials. He has a partnership with, like, Budweiser. He's going crazy.
So you trying to say he's the king of what, hip-hop right now?
He is, isn't he?
No.
He's probably the biggest.
I'm just asking. To be honest, we're looking at the stats.
I think he's probably the biggest.
How fucked up is that?
He's just the biggest artist out right now, and he just happens to have a bunch of songs.
How does he get the hip-hop tag? That's the question I'm asking.
Because he gets a bunch of his music.
Because to me, that music doesn't sound like hip-hop.
The people who write it are pop hip-hop artists.
It's a subcategory. It's like
the people that write the music are hip-hop artists.
For hip-hop. Pop.
It's out of control, man.
You do? The people who write the music are hip hop artists, so you know.
Yeah, like Joey Badass.
Yeah. Mm. And he has songs with rappers like 21 Savage and Travis Scott, so they're gonna include him as in with rap.
Is that the trick? You get enough of those songs that counts as hip hop, and
I guess.
Yeah, that's the trick.
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
Sneak in like that.
He's it's like a substitute. It's like a
Trojan.
No, it's just a different section of hip hop. You know, in all.
Yeah, well, hip hop. You think hip hop should be broken up into different sections?
Yeah,
you think so?
I think so. That's pop hip hop for me.
It'd be like forever.
It'd be like rap and beat.
It'd be like gender now.
It'd be like rap and beat.
Every day
like,
there'd be a new one. This is
hip hop.
This is New Jersey down east side, New Jersey hip hop. Yeah. So this is a whole different genre. So you can only judge us against each other. Nah, I can't do that.
Nah, right?
Yeah, that's not gonna work.
I'm good. He's not. He's definitely not the guy. He's definitely not the king of hip hop or the face of hip hop, if that's what you're.
Nah. Well, I'm talking right. about the king, one of the kings of hip hop.
Hov, what's
nah,
up, man?
Nah, what your man
he signed. He signed another man, free agent or something.
Nick, I mean your man Eminem dissed Nick Cannon on Fat Joe's new album Out of Nowhere.
Yo, don't even put the Reggie up. Put the fucking dirt. If you find dirt anywhere. Put it on the screen.
Put K2 on it. K2.
Reggie Midlove.
We're not doing Reggie Midlove.
We're not doing Reggie Midlove.
Reggie
Midlove. Eminem. It's not happening. It's not happening.
It's some subliminal bullshit.
Yeah, we're not doing that.
We know what the rating system is. We'll just rate how we want to rate.
So what? Let's get your opinions on Eminem on that.
On his bars.
Fat Joe. Yeah, his bars were trash.
First of all. I don't even know who was the first one that was rapping on that song.
Dre. Cool and Dre.
Oh, okay.
Because it's like him and Fat Joe's album.
Got it.
Yeah, man, it sounds so good. Fat Joe, I don't know, I skipped it. And I went straight to the Eminem. That's the only thing I would care for. And it sounded okay. It sounded way better than what Nick Cannon said.
In retaliation.
In retaliation. Wow, that was so bad, that Nick Cannon shit. What was the word of the day?
Egregious.
That was egregiously bad. Egregiously. Wow.
That was egregious.
That was crazy. I didn't finish either verse, neither. Let me tell you, I didn't finish the Eminem verse, and I didn't finish the Nick Cannon verse. I gave them both like 30 seconds, and that's all they had.
So what I wanted to say about this whole thing is, mm-hmm. I was forced to listen to this filth.
Yeah.
All right? And I was like they're playing it because they want me to hear what it is.
Yeah.
And this is, you know, garbage because it's a whole bunch of garbage people battling against each other.
Can you put the emoji with the guy throwing the trash for this for me?
Yes.
That's what I want.
Definitely.
It's not the Reggie. I want the trash.
And yeah, that all of that shit sucks. All of that is garbage and it's not worth listening to. Yeah, so don't do it.
What do you think about Roddy Ricch's album?
Okay. Roddy Ricch.
Roddy Ricch's album.
Well, just to be honest, man, I'm loving Roddy Ricch right now.
He's getting better and better every time.
Yeah, he's one of the new wave, the new next generation rappers that I think he has a bright future. He has what, 2-3 projects that I think are like amazing, awesome projects. He just dropped a new project.
The album is Please Excuse Me for Being Antisocial.
Okay.
Wow.
Okay. That sounds like the times.
Okay.
That sounds like what the times would be like.
Speaking of depressing, R.I.P. Juice WRLD.
R.I.P. Juice.
Yeah, R.I.P. Juice WRLD, man.
Wow, that was...
That's sad.
Very sad.
I'm not really sure about all the facts. Every second there's a new report, and all the reports sound...
And TMZ definitely is in my media. All the reports
sound spooky and sad.
Yeah,
and like they all could have been avoided. So kids.
So it says that the pilots notified the police that allegedly Juice WRLD and his entourage were had 70 pounds of bud, pills, and guns, and he supposedly swallowed a few to keep them away from the police, and ultimately died from cardiac arrest, I believe. And I saw a report that came out today that this wasn't the first time that he's had a run-in with the authorities or FBI when it comes to bud and planes and stuff like that. They stopped him before. Yeah. So I think he was trying to just stay low, which is unfortunate.
Yeah, that's real sad. Juice WRLD super young. I think he just turned 21 or something.
Yeah,
right?
He turned 21 a couple days ago.
You have to be, man.
You got to be super careful.
Sometimes
you gotta
it's not worth
take
it.
Care of your health, man. It's the most important thing.
Sometimes give your lawyer a chance. That was unfortunate.
Yeah, give your lawyer a chance. I feel that.
You know, man.
And also, you know, if you're going to do some stuff, man, pay the people a good amount. This doesn't happen.
Pay your weed man enough careful. To take the 70-pound charge.
And there's a whole bunch of y'all on the plane, and you have the stuff. There's so many ways to get rid of it.
I don't understand.
It doesn't make sense. There's something missing.
Like crush it up, throw it in water, flush it down
flush
the toilet.
Flush it down the toilet. Everybody take one. There's a whole bunch of us.
Yeah, there's mad of us.
Well, you know, people panic,
I don't know.
People panic.
But that's sad. R.I.P. Juice WRLD.
Facts.
You made some fire.
Let me ask you a question.
Yeah.
How much do you think people make a year off like their music that aren't current active artists?
Oh, no.
It depends on...
I think millions.
On, you know, like, when you see how much money the... Like, are you saying how much money their estate makes? Like their name makes? Like, the artist? Or how much do they take home?
Like, for example, let's say an artist that was popping in the 90s before like, streams and stuff.
Like who?
Busta Rhymes. Let's say for argument's sake.
Nah, I don't think
how much music do you think Busta Rhymes' estate makes a year?
Over $1 million.
I'd say around a million.
Yeah, over $1 million, I would say.
Hey, man.
Like
that's
a
not
million
bad.
And a dollar.
Over that.
That's over.
Over $1 million.
Bro, that's really good.
What do you think?
I think that's really good. A million, that's good. That's success.
Maybe it could be more.
And it could be more.
But I
even
say,
if it's 500,000 a year, that's just a stream of revenue, bro. That's just
I think it's more than that.
Chicken that's just coming in.
Yeah, but yeah, I think they would make a lot of money.
Them rapper checks be slowing up, I feel.
If you have a lot of classic music, timeless music that gets used in like commercials and and movies and TV shows.
Mm-hmm. All those jingles.
You're going to make.
No, you're definitely going to have a royalty charge.
And you're still going to get some streams. Like, you might not get a billion streams like these new guys.
Like, whoever's.
But you can still get hundreds of millions of streams.
Whoever's in the Baby Boy money. Soundtrack is probably Wild Rich from BET. Like, whoever's in that soundtrack.
Wow, Baby Boy is always on BET.
I know, so the royalties are crazy.
You could turn to BET and they're playing Baby Boy.
So that's what I'm saying. Whoever's on the soundtrack of Baby Boy, mo money.
Chicken.
All right, so I got.
So who else do you think? You think Busta Rhymes makes a million? Who else do you think makes? Who else from the 90s? You think?
Nas is still making money. Well, see, I don't know how much the take home is because I feel like a lot of them have bad deals.
Yeah, but at
where
this point,
there's cuts coming out and stuff, and they're not getting all that money, nowhere close to it.
Yeah,
so, but Nas himself, the person, could have pulled in like $7 million.
See, I think Nas has mad other businesses. I think he has the same.
We're just talking about music, though,
okay,
right?
Okay, yeah.
Like, he might have pulled in $7 million off his music or $6 million off his music, but take home, I don't think, is anywhere like that. You know what I'm trying to say?
Right.
People are still getting their.
The Nas estate makes $6 million, but Nas himself brought home 1.2 or something.
And I don't
like
even want to say like numbers like that, but like
I'm just making up. Yeah. I'm making up numbers.
Yeah.
Sorry,
I can agree with that. Yo, so I have a situation for you guys, and then I have a moral question. And the moral question this week is super dark. It's super dark. Like, a warning. It's warning. It's
what do you mean
warning?
Warning.
Like, it's crazy.
Warning.
So I just want to know where your guys' heads at on. This first situation, okay?
Okay.
So let's say you guys have a friend, like he's a really good friend, one of your best friends, one of the gang. One of the guys.
Gang.
And
the lighter flicks.
So he's one of the guys, right? And he moves away. Let's say right before college or you know, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
He moves away. And you guys don't really see him as much, but he still stays in contact.
Okay, you see his IG?
Yeah, you know, and every now and then, you know, he'll call you up or whatever. But you don't really see him anymore. It's been a couple years. Then one year out of the blue, he calls you guys up and he's like, I'm coming back to visit. I want to see everybody. I want to meet everybody. And I want to introduce y'all to somebody.
Okay.
Right?
Oh, yeah.
So he pulls up. Let's say it's like Thanksgiving, Friendsgiving. He pulls up and he brings his fiancée.
Wow, this this starting to sound like some Black Mirror shit.
So then, he brings his fiance, and his fiance happens to be a girl that used to live in your neighborhood.
Okay,
that all of you are familiar with, and when I say familiar with, I mean you've known her.
The groupie. Oh my god!
And you've maybe known her simultaneously.
Did you meet her at the door?
What do you do? He pulls up into the function. Hey, everybody, I'd like you guys to meet my fiance. And it's her. And
it's Stephanie.
What if it's.
And it's Stephanie from the neighborhood.
What if it.
We all know.
What if it.
What do you do?
Has Stephanie ever moved away?
She moved away too.
Okay, has it been 10
and
plus
she
years?
She moved away. She moved away because it got so crazy. She had to move away because it got crazy.
Maybe if it's been 10 plus years, maybe that like, you know.
No, like, it got so crazy that like, as soon as she came in, everybody was like, oh. Like, even the parents, like there were some older people there too.
Oh,
like,
you got
shit.
The
older?
Like, she was like, hey. She was like smashing on like, the hey. Like, outside.
Like
on
she couldn't help herself. She loved it.
Oh.
Oh, well, then if that's the case, then I can't I can't let my man be with a.
But she could
embarrass him.
But she could have changed now. What you mean embarrass him? You think he would mind?
All right, well,
you think he needs to know?
I mean, if it's been not that long of a time, then he needs to know. But if it's been mad long, then
it's been 5 years.
He doesn't need to know.
He's my Eskimo brother.
No, but it's not just you. Now. Like, you're in a room. About four or five of you have known him.
Okay, I think he doesn't need to know because he doesn't even live around here no more. They live wherever they live, away from us, doing their thing. So let them just continue to do their thing.
What if
she's
like...
She's changed.
But then she could always, at one point in time, they could be having a fight, and she could always be like, yeah, that's why I fucked all your friends, and they knew, and they still ain't say shit. They don't give a fuck about you.
I mean, then that's what? A grime person. Yeah, what you should the break fuck? Up with her.
I think during a fight, and then he's gonna be friends, should, like, nah, how y'all do me like that?
Because would you call your friends grime? I don't know. I wouldn't necessarily call my friends grime for that. I'd be like,
for not saying it.
Yeah, like you're the grime. Short. I think you you're would. The grime person for not for bringing it out now.
Like, what do you think, Bleak?
That's my Eskimo brother.
So you are.
So
yes,
so,
yeah, that is yes. true. Yes, yes.
Technically that is correct. He is it. Your Eskimo brother.
That's it.
And then
then we have fun.
Will he know
all together?
Will he know? Yes, I will tell him.
Okay.
Of all the good times, now we can share that.
Oh, you tell him immediately.
I'll tell him. Of course.
Let me talk to you real quick. Yo, you all smashed.
Yeah, my guy.
What if he's like, yo, I loved her.
All right, you love her, bro. That's what's up. But you know.
What I was trying to say is, flip it around. You're the guy that moved and you came back. Do you want to know?
That
yes.
Yes. Oh.
Yes.
Yeah, I want to know.
Immediately.
Yeah.
Would you break up with her?
Nah.
That she had like 7-8 dudes like.
No, she used to get it in. Like she used to get it in. Like everybody loves her. Like it's not. It's nothing negative. It's like
the whole blockhead
niggas. They're on it. Like what's up? Yo, Stephanie, yo, what's good?
Hey, yo, Stephanie.
Stephanie's back? Oh, Stephanie. That's Stephanie.
Like, oh, shit, that's Stephanie.
It's lit. No disrespect to Stephanie. That's an amazing name. We love Stephanies.
Yes, we do.
I call that Stephanie.
Oh, yo.
Young and May.
Chill out. Don't get don't get G-O. Well, how would you? No, over here with Young and May, baby.
How would you? Well, how would you?
I definitely want to know.
Immediately. And would you break up with her?
We'd have a conversation.
But what's the problem? You love her. This is the past.
It is the past.
So she cannot be forgiven for anything she's done in the past. Do you expect for her to forgive you for things that you haven't told her in the past?
Yeah, I haven't been like, I mean, 10 women haven't just like thrown themselves at me, so. I mean.
It doesn't have to be 10 women throwing themselves
at one time.
It doesn't have to be that.
Oh, but
there's probably things that you haven't told, you know? Like, do you want her to judge you for those things?
Yeah, she can.
Okay.
So good.
Bleak?
What do you mean, judge me? What do you mean, judge me?
I'm saying, would you be able to handle that?
Uh-huh.
And would you be able to handle that, first of all?
If I knew already, right? Or no?
No, you don't know.
Oh, I don't
You're
know.
You're just finding that out.
Boom, I walk in, then my boys tell me.
Your boys tell you, listen, we've been with her.
We've been with her.
Many different ways, yeah. Various different ways. She's amazing. We love her. She should be a professional.
Yes. Well, right there and then, it'll probably sink. It'll crush me.
It'll crush you immediately?
It'll crush me immediately.
But you love her.
But I love her.
But this was the past. It's not during you. She didn't cheat on you.
Then, you know, you kind of like, you bring the understanding to it. Like, it happened a long time ago and all that, but.
Like, she used to get crazy. Yeah. There might even be, like, footage of this.
I mean,
like, you could type in her old nickname, like, oh, Steffi Heffy or whatever.
Wow.
And then on whatever you go to, whatever streaming services you use.
Are we going back videos. From where
like
we came?
They're old, though. They're old school.
That's what I'm saying. But are we going back like, from where we came from?
They look like they were shot on an Android or something.
So, damn. You love her? You've been with her for what? 10, 15 years already?
At least, what? We said, what? 5 years you've been with her?
5 years?
So you've been with her for 5 years.
5 years. I think I might just leave her.
Just immediately? Just leave her? Like, it's over?
Nah. I don't know. Let's see.
No, I'm just saying, that's it? You're done? Could you live with that?
Can you live with that? Wow. Because then you got to see your boys again.
Let's say you got a job. Let's say you got a job back home. That's why you moved first to introduce them and to let everybody know you're coming back home to live here. You got a fire job back here.
No, I probably couldn't live with that.
So you'd break up with her. It's over.
Yeah. Would you tell
her?
That's fucked
up. If all my friends did something with her, nah.
I don't think.
But
I love her,
right?
Yeah, I feel like if you love her, it's not that easy. You think it's that easy? So then you didn't really love her then.
That's what I'm saying.
That's got to be a battle.
I'm just talking.
Who cares about the past,
I'm
right?
Not just talking, but it's hard, yo.
It's hard, man.
Guys, yeah, tell us in the comments, please, tell us in the comments how you feel about that. Could you live with the fact that far back in the past, years ago, your current significant other, your current girlfriend, boyfriend, has had sex with a lot of your friends?
Nah, you can't.
Most of your friends in... Amazing ways.
I'm out. I'm out. I'm out. I'm out of there.
I'm out.
But this is the past, though.
Nah.
Several years ago.
Nah, I'm good. I'm out.
Share the homies.
Nah. Right? It ain't no fun if the...
If the homies,
can't... You know what I mean?
It ain't no fun if the homies can't have none.
It's true. It ain't.
No fun.
Yeah, I think that I would like to think that I'm mature enough to, if these are my friends, you know what I mean? Why would I be mad if my friends had sex with my girl in the past? These are my friends. Obviously, my girl is fire, right? They all wanted to have sex with her. And now that's they true. Can't. Only I can. It's not official. And if I love you, I don't care about your past.
Good luck, sir.
What if you met her when she first moved to the new spot and she just finished? Okay, let me ask you a question.
Yes, ma'am.
Is this a crump question?
No. I heard your question and I'm trying to expound on it.
You're going somewhere else.
Yeah. So she moves. It got all crazy at home, right? So she moves away.
And when we say all crazy, just to clarify, she was knowing everybody.
Yeah.
She was getting physical.
Oh.
All over the town.
What? She couldn't get a respectable relationship going because everybody in the town knew her to be.
No, maybe it's. Listen, why does it have to be? She couldn't get it. Maybe she just enjoyed having sex and she didn't feel any kind of way about it. And a woman should be able to enjoy her body however she seems fit.
Women should enjoy your
bodies, okay?
It's okay to be.
If you want to have sex with many people, that's your right. It's your right to have sex with whoever you want to.
Right.
Get it in. Just be careful, be safe, and you know. Know that there's,
So
there's
rewards
and risks.
It gets crazy at home. She leaves, right? You meet her as soon as she moves to the new spot.
Okay, I meet her. She moves to the new spot.
She moves to the new spot where you've been living for the past 5, 6, 7 years.
Okay.
And you meet her as soon as she moves in. I mean, she moves down the block. You see her moving. So on
y'all
and so
vibe.
Forth.
Y'all catch a vibe.
Y'all vibe. Y'all start dating for 5 years, right?
Mm-hmm.
You don't make a home for another 5 years. You come home after 5 years, and now they show you they the same situation where it's like as soon as she left from doing that, you met her, and now they're like, yeah, like 5 years ago she left. She was just doing this, so she's just fresh off of. So you met her just fresh off of jumping or whatever you want to, say. And so does that have anything to do with it? Like, does that change your answer at all?
Say the last part one more time, because the wording is...
So like, I feel the way you set it up was like, it's like she left and it was 5 years that she's been not
she's
doing that.
She could have left earlier. It could be more than 5 years that she left, if that helps. Your scenario. If it doesn't, then you can leave it.
I guess my scenario is she meets you as soon as she moves away from doing crazy the crazy shit.
Yeah.
And now when you do come back, they're telling you, yeah, she was just doing that when she just left. Like, right before she left, she was doing that. When'd you meet her? They're like, yo, I met her in August, blah, blah, blah. They're like, yo, she was just doing that in July. But right before you left, she just did meet my man in the third.
I'm confused about the scenario just a little bit. So it was right before she turned a new leaf. Like she was muddy.
She turned
all crazy.
She was muddy
all crazy.
She turned a new leaf.
And then
with you.
The next month she meets you and she starts a new.
Yeah.
Next month.
Okay, what's the question? Am I okay with that?
Yeah.
Yo, if I can't, listen, I don't care about that stuff. I'm different. You know what I mean? If that's who you were and you're not like that no more, or you change, you take it, I don't
care
about that.
She's learning to be that with you.
She's learning?
Yeah, she's not still jumping. I mean, she's not doing that with other people, but I mean.
Yeah, like we'll take it one step at a time. Like this is a whole new leaf. We turn a new page.
That's cool.
The past is the past.
All right. What's the other scenario? Is that the dark one?
That one is dark.
That was the dark one.
Yeah, man, let's go. Right,
this one wasn't dark. This one is better.
By the way,
this is a dark one.
This is a show on Netflix called Dark. Hell of a show. You should watch it.
Okay, Dark on Netflix. I'll put it on the list. Not until y'all watch Top Boy, y'all grind. All right, this is the dark scenario. This is dark, guys. Are you ready?
Let's go.
It's scary.
Let's go.
Somehow you've been abducted by a gang of hoodlums. What's the scariest type of hoodlums right now? What do you want to do? Like a gang. It could be some
Mexican mafia.
Like some MS-13 something like that.
Like cartel.
Like the cartel. That's pretty scary, right? The cartel kidnaps you and your significant other, uh-huh. right? And they're on some fucked up shit. There's mistaken yeah. identity. They think you're someone else.
Yeah.
And they're convinced it's you, so they're giving some twist. You know how it gets if you owe them money or something bad's right. happening. It's some twisted, fucked up situation.
Yes.
And the situation is, this is how twisted and fucked up it is. They're okay. like, listen, man, we don't give a about your lives. We don't care. Mm-hmm. We're just going to play around. And this is your two choices. And they go to you. Mm-hmm. And they hand you a rusty, disgusting, serrated, like, knife. It's serrated and it's rusty and disgusting. Big, like, almost on a machete.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And they say, listen, you can stab your wife with this until she dies. And then I let you go free. Mm-hmm. You can do nothing at all, right? And I'll kill both of you. Like, we'll kill both of you, like, in some, as slow as we want to. We'll chop you up piece by piece until you're done, yeah. right? Mm-hmm. Or you can let all of us run train on your wife, and you have to watch it, and then we'll let you live, and you can get out of here. Nah,
man. So the only way she lives is if you let them run the train on her.
Yeah.
Kill us both.
And they're gonna kill you like disgustingly, like tie you up and chop you up piece at a time. Like, how do you get out of this situation?
All right, where's that knife?
Would you like, where's that, clarify, so where's that knife? Here, it's right here, sir. And it's over for her?
I'm only kidding.
It's over?
No, I'm not stabbing, I'm not killing my wife, no. It's like me make it and she doesn't. If I kill her, we both die, or we both live, and she has the train ran on her. I'm gonna just say we both die. Fuck it.
Bleak.
I'm crazy.
Bleak.
I'm thinking about this, and I think I'll stab her.
Stab her up?
Yeah.
Let her die by your hands?
Yes.
Okay.
You're not raping her, and you're not killing her, so I'm gonna do it. And then whatever happens to me, happens to me.
You get to walk home.
Oh, I get to... Oh, nah, wait, whoa. I thought that wasn't... I get to walk home?
After you kill her, you get to go home.
Oh, shit. I thought it was that I die after that.
No, you get to get out of there. If you kill her, you're out of there. They just let you go home.
Oh, man. Well, that's called survival.
What are you doing?
Me?
Yeah.
So, to be perfectly honest, like... I know the trauma from going through something like that, some kind of like assault like that, must be crazy. And I never had that, so I don't know, I don't understand how that is. But I would want to have a conversation. They probably wouldn't let me have a conversation with my girl. But I would like to ask my girl, if she wants to live. Is living the most important shit to her?
Of course it is.
And if she can't live with that, if she can't live with it, then I will stab her down.
If she can't live with what?
Having him go to town on her.
Oh, okay.
If she's like, yeah, I don't think I can live with that.
So you don't mind.
I'd be like,
my
sweet darling, I'll take care of the kids.
So if she was down, you'd let her do that?
Hmm?
I mean, if she was down, right. you'd be like, okay, babe, go do that.
If she was down, then that's her choice, yes.
Yeah.
How many men are there?
Six, seven.
Mm. Wow.
And they're all 6'7".
Oh. Yeah.
Well, we said a Mexican cartel, so.
Oh.
No.
That's not racist.
4'7".
Yeah.
Now that's racist. Now it's racist. Nah. Oh. Yeah, my, but like 6 or 7 of them.
Yeah.
But what would you do?
I don't know, man.
You said you couldn't do it, you're out of there.
I don't know. Yeah.
And you said that you would
stab her.
Yeah. Yeah. I think I'd be like, baby, what? Can you do it?
Babe, they told me to stab you first, then they're stabbing me, so I'm doing this first.
What if it's flipped around the other way and your girl asks you, like, yo, but what do you want to do? They're going to run a train on you. Like,
oh, nah, you stab dudes? Me. Like, stab me.
You stab me.
We're dead.
Nah,
we're
dying.
Can you live with it, babe? Or like,
you can stab me.
You're just gonna die?
We are both dying.
Oh, we're both dying?
Oh.
Oh, she can't kill you?
Nah, no. she can kill me.
Yeah, she can kill me.
Yeah, baby girl, you can kill me. Go away.
Take care of the kids.
Fuck out of here.
And you still can't drive my car.
Yeah.
Unless it's Sunday. All right, funny thing, and let's get out of here.
Funny thing? Man. What's the funny thing?
Did you have a funny thing, Bleak?
Funny thing, I don't know. But I do have those guys. This one of the listeners. I was on Instagram, and this guy, guy I'm wearing today, Tony Peralta, he put up a post about him being a culture vulture. And this podcast out up in the Heights, I think they're from there. I'm not too sure. I just listened to that one episode. But they said that he was, well, one of them agreed that he was a culture vulture. The other one didn't. One of them, I think, played it as if he didn't know who he was. But his peers said that he was a culture vulture. Mm-hmm. So I don't know if they really understood what that is. But if you do know him, you know that he's not. You feel me? He's only but represented who he is and what the culture that he knows is. And he's been able to install other things to it.
What culture is that?
Dominican.
Okay.
So he gets the Bleak stamp of approval.
Yeah, he gets approval.
He's not a culture vulture.
He's not a culture vulture.
And I believe you. If Bleak says it, I believe it.
Yeah, so I just kind of wanted to.
That's what's up.
Yeah, man. Just got to let that know.
And as always, we went all over the place. We got crazy.
Yeah.
But it's the Blunt Exchange. That's how we do it. Mm-hmm. And we keep it blunt. We roll up.
We talk
facts.
You know what I mean? And sometimes it goes all over the place. We'll always try to do better next time.
Yeah.
Once again, it's
Crump.
Pablo, a.k.a. Bleak.
AIM. It's the Blunt Exchange. Thanks for watching.
Holla!
Don't forget, follow us on all platforms. Twitter, Blunt Exchange. Instagram, Blunt Exchange. Facebook, Blunt Exchange. And you're already here, YouTube, Blunt Exchange. Don't forget to subscribe, like the videos, hit the notification bell, and send us a comment.